Hello, and welcome to a setting up OBS tutorial kind of thing. In this, I'll show you how to set up, like, just go over general settings for streaming and recording with OBS. I already assume you know how to get OBS, you've downloaded it. I hate when tutorials go over that. First, go to settings, and then settings right there. Should bring up a window like this. Now, for this setting profile, in this very first tab, general setting profile, if you put a name here, if you click add, it will create a new profile with that name, or you can rename an existing one, or you can delete a profile. The good thing about profiles, like for me, I have one profile for streaming and one profile for recording. So I don't have to keep going in here and changing settings and stuff. So on to the next tab, encoding. Check this encoder by 264. Check use CBR, check CBR padding, check custom buffer size. I'm just going to go over all the stuff that's going to be the same for everyone. So I'm going to come back to this max bit rate and buffer size later, because that will vary depending on your internet speed. For this audio section, set codec to AAC, format to 48 kilohertz, bit rate to 128. This bit rate, it might change per internet. It should be fine at this for all the things that I go over. Channel, stereo. Okay, in broadcast settings, for streaming, you want to set this very first tab to live stream. And, you know, whatever service you use, I use Twitch. Don't really know what to use for anything else because I use Twitch. Alright, for this tab, this FMS URL, please click that, and you'll see a drop down of all the different places that you can stream to. So, usually people leave this on default or just pick whatever's closest to them. That's not a good idea. What you want to do is go to Google, search speed test. The very first link, speedtest.net by Ookla. Go to that. And, right. On this list, pick like three or four of the closest servers to you. If not, just said that was bad, but pick three or four of them and test all of those and see which one you have the highest upload speed on. This your result should look like this for each server. Ping, we don't care about. Download speed, we don't care about, because we're uploading, we're streaming. What we care about is this number right here. Right, I said I was going to go over this at the end. Right, well, I'll go over it now. So my upload speed, or the best one that I can get from that list of servers, is 2.32. Close these. All right. Well, keep that number in mind. I'll come back to it when I go over the rest of this stuff. So, you can check auto reconnect if you like. This means if your internet goes down, OBS will automatically try to restart the stream. So, say you're playing a game full screen or something, and it's really annoying to alt tab out of, and your internet just goes down for a couple seconds. This is really good because then you don't have to tab out of the game, it'll just automatically restart. This auto reconnect timeout, that's how long it will wait before it attempts to reconnect. I have it set to default 10, If you set this lower, it'll kind of just spam a lot more. I think 10 is a fine number. It gives it enough time for your internet to come back up and stuff. This delay in seconds, naturally, the delay when streaming to Twitch is, you know, 5 to 20 seconds. Most people are like, oh my god, Twitch increased the delay to 45 seconds to a minute, it's so bad. If you actually pay attention, it's like 5 to 20 seconds. This delay in seconds adds to that. So let's say if this is set to 0 and you have a 5 second delay, if you increase this to 10, your new delay will be 15 seconds, which is when you do something on the screen and 15 seconds later they will see it on, your viewers will see it on your stream. Minimize network impact. Don't really know if that's good or bad. I haven't checked because my internet sucks. This automatically saves stream to file. If you want to record and stream at the same time, you can check that, specify a file location. I don't do that. If I want to upload something I streamed, I just go download the stream. That way I don't have all these files on my computer taking up tons of space. Also, if you get a warning right here in red, warning, your OBS settings are not good, blah 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 blah, just ignore it. Go with the settings that I tell you, everything will be fine. Alright, so video tab. This video adapter should be good. I think it either says like default or whatever your video card is. You shouldn't really have to mess with too much on this. Base resolution. You really want to find out what resolution your monitor is. If you don't know how to do that, I'm sure Google can help. My monitor resolution is 1920 by 1080. And I stream at 720p, 60fps, which I'll come back to that later in the bitrate setup stuff. For audio, your desktop audio, microphone audio, default should be fine. If you're having audio issues, like people can't hear you, or they can't hear the game, then you might have to mess with these, but default should be fine. If you do have to change them, check this show only connected devices, and then your drop-down list should be a little bit smaller and easier to go through and see what works. This push-to-talk delay, I don't use that because why would you want a delay on push-to-talk? Desktop boost and microphone boost. On the actual OBS screen, here, you see these two slider bars, or two staircases. You can adjust your microphone and desktop volumes. So if this one on the left, if you move this down, your microphone will be quieter. If you move it up, it'll be louder. This is your desktop. If you move that down, quieter, louder. Here. Bring this. I'm using OBS to record. That's why I'm using this photo thing. But you can see right here, this green bar, that's me talking. If I let go of push to talk, you see it completely went down. But I can lower this, and I'll be really quiet, I'm pretty sure. I can raise it, and I should be back to normal. This one is for your microphone, so it's just you talking. This one is everything that you can hear, like the game, or people you're talking to on like Mumble or Skype, or anything coming out of your speakers is this one. Okay, back to this. I'm spending so much time on this. Okay, hotkeys. I use push-to-talk. Not a lot of people use, or not a lot of people, but generally people that stream don't use push-to-talk, but I really prefer to use push-to-talk because if I'm not talking, I don't want you to hear like or whatever. I don't breathe like that, but still, I don't want you to hear that. I don't want there to be any kind of background static when I'm not talking, or if I'm typing, I don't want tons of key presses and stuff. So you can set these however you want. I don't use any of these. You can mess with that all you want. I don't care. Alright, so advanced tab. This pretty much needs to be the same for everyone. Don't even know why they let people edit this stuff. So all the default stuff should be normal and you shouldn't have to change it. But just in case you accidentally click some stuff and you don't know what it is, or you accidentally hit stuff and you didn't mean to, use multi-thread on, check that, process priority normal, scene buffering 700, that's how long you're giving your computer to render a scene before it sends it out. 700 should be perfectly fine, don't touch it. Disable encoding while previewing. That, just leave it unchecked. Allow other modifiers on hotkeys, check that. Video 264 CPU preset, very fast. Encoding profile, high. These two, if you change it just a little bit, it's going to lag like crazy. So make sure it's set to these. These should be default values. Keyframe interval. This one, it gave me the biggest amount of trouble for the longest time, but you do need to set this to 2. Default is 0, and Twitch does not like that. I think it's something to do with you're making sure the stream is synced with synced with the upload or whatever. It's something. Just set it to 2. Everything will be fine. Check these two boxes. Use CFR, custom encoder settings. Don't check any of this stuff. Yeah, this should be 0 default 20. You can read. If any of this is too fuzzy, set it to, I forgot to say this at the beginning, but set it to like theater mode or full screen. Should be pretty readable. Might be a little grainy or whatever. Alright, this tab, Quick Sync Encoder, this is completely new to me, and it's all grayed out anyway, so I can't, I can't edit it. So I have no idea what the heck this is. It might be all grayed out for you as well, so don't worry about it. Microphone noise gate. This is if you are not using push to talk. This will automatically turn your microphone on or off when it thinks you're talking. So this open threshold, when you say something, your voice goes above a certain level. That's when you want it to broadcast your voice. And then when it goes below a certain level, this closed threshold, that's when you want it to turn off so you don't have like background static or breathing or whatever. I don't really trust this, so I just use push to talk, but you can do it. Just mess around with it, see what works, what doesn't. I mean, you should be able to see this green bar here whenever you're talking or whatever your background noise is, or whenever it's activating and stuff, and you should be able to tell what good thresholds and stuff are. Okay, so this is for recording. The only tab that is different between recording and streaming is this broadcast settings, this mode, set it to file output only instead of live stream or whatever it was. And this will record a video like I am now. It'll just pretty much streaming to a file on your computer instead of to Twitch. Alright, so one thing you do need, what was that? In this tab, broadcast settings, if this for this path or stream key, what you need to do is go to twitch.tv/your username/dashboard/stream key. If you're logged in, you should see something that says show stream key. Click that, copy paste that link into that box, and that will link your OBS to your stream channel. As an example, my stream channel is algorithm44, so twitch.tv/algorithm44/dashboard/stream key. Alright, so now for bitrate, upload speed, whatever you want to call it. Alright, so what we need to do is calculate our magic number, so to say. This is upload speed times 750. Why 750? Because we get our upload speed in Mbps, and we need to convert it to Kbps. So there's 1000 K in 1 M. So, calculator. My upload speed, where was it? Was 2.32. So if we take that and we multiply by 750, that gives me my magic number. That was different earlier. Whatever. So my magic number is 1740. Now I made a little chart here. My magic number falls in this 1500 to 2000 range. So what I keep forgetting this. We're multiplying by 75% because we don't want to use all of our upload speed. We want to use roughly 75% of it, because if you use all of your upload speed, and your computer's not going to be able to upload anything else, like data to a game, like saying, I'm moving my character now, or you want to give it a little bit of room, and you want some room for games and stuff. So you don't want to use all of your upload speed. Anyway, my upload falls in this range. So I set my bitrate, where it is. Nope, not that tab. Nope, not that one. Dang it. Yeah, there we go. I set my bitrate to 1500. As you can see here, and also set my resolution to 720p, which is, dang it, I need to make these icons bigger. Nope, not that one. No, not that one. Dang it, where is it? There it is. Video settings. There we go. Resolution downscale. I set that to 1280 by 720. You can see right there. This number right here doesn't really mean anything. What you want to look at is the number in parentheses. Alright, so I have it set to that. If your magic number, this one right here, is greater than 2000, you can stream, or you should be able to stream at 1080p. If it is between 1000 and 1500, you should be able to stream at 480p. And if it's between 500,000, 360p, and if it's below 500, it's kind of tough luck. You most likely can't stream because that is really bad upload. You can attempt to do this one, but it's probably going to be very laggy, and you know, probably won't be able to do it. Alright, so for recording, you don't have to worry about upload speed, so there's no magic number calculations or anything. This is what resolution that you want to record in. Like right now, I am recording in 1080p, and I have my bitrate set to 8,000. I did some looking online, and I found a chart that said it should be 6,000. That doesn't sound right. It should be 8,000. 720p, 6,000. 480p, 4,000. 360p, 2,000. This is what the online chart says. I don't really trust that. I would suggest you use these. In your OBS, if you see down here, I think it'll, about here where it says drop frames, if there's something that comes up that says warning, high encoding, or like it's having issues, then you probably have to choose a lower resolution because your computer can't handle it. I think that's all. Yeah, that's all. So, holy crap, this was a very long video, but you should have everything you need to know to set up OBS. I'll try and remember to put some annotations or something to skip to different parts. But you should have everything to do all these settings. It should be good to go. You shouldn't have to adjust any of these settings once you find some settings that work for you. If you want, I can do a video showing you how to set up these scenes and stuff, but this video is for setting up OBS. How about that? Not for actually implementing it. Anyway, I guess I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.